Hello everyone, welcome to Sunburned Albino Plays Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc Episode 10. I should be streaming right now, but I don't have anything to stream, so instead I'm just going to record a bunch more of these. I'm like 3 episodes ahead of what you're seeing on YouTube right now. In terms of real time, but yeah, okay, whatever. So, if we remember from last episode, we have to go back to the library to analyze some extension cord nonsense, like see what's going on there, but also we need to come downstairs and talk to Celeste, who evidently saw something. All I do now is think about this game when I'm not... if I'm going to bed, I'll just, like, lay awake for, like, a half hour and just think about, like, just what's going on in Danganronpa. Oh, hey, Taco, what's up? How unfortunate. Maybe we should have confessed our embarrassing secrets after all. Damn it! I'm sorry, Chihiro! It's all because I wasn't strong enough! Yeah. I mean, no, but, you know. Right, she's in the warehouse, which is over here. Like, yes, you can teleport, but I still don't know how to do that. At least in terms of having it work. Alright, let's go in. So yeah, I'll tell you my theory in a bit. First, we gotta see what Celeste has got going on. Celeste, what are you doing here? This warehouse is amazing. It has absolutely everything one might need to live a full life. From food, to clothes, to towels, there's an endless supply to choose from. I see that, but have you found anything related to the case?
Most unfortunate.
I knew you were going to ask me that. I thought talking about the warehouse itself might misdirect you, but I see it was pointless. Then you did find something? Very well, I will tell you and only you.
Actually,
last night, I saw her here. Chihiro was in the warehouse. What? Really?
Indeed.
This was right before nighttime.
What are you doing out this late?
Oh, you're... Okay, you do it.
Oh, I was just...
Are you planning to go exercise, perhaps?
What? How did you know?
Because I can see a blue track jacket sticking out of that duffel bag you're carrying.
Oh, you're right. Thanks. Well, I'd better get going. I'm kind of in a hurry.
She stuffed the jacket into her bag in a hurry. It was almost like she was trying to hide it. And just like that, she was gone.
Yes,
indeed. I assumed she was merely stocking up to go exercise in the morning, but it would appear she ignored the nighttime rule and headed directly to the girls' locker room. If she hadn't broken our rule, none of this ever would have happened. You get what you deserve, I suppose. So apparently, she went to the girls' locker room late at night in order to exercise without anyone knowing. But the strange thing is, there was no trace of the track jacket or duffel bag Celeste said she saw Chihiro carrying, which would mean the killer would have gotten rid of it somehow. She would have gotten rid of it. Where would you put the... Do I gotta go in the trash room again? I'll do it. If people are still... You know, someone said like, oh, Leon screwed up the trash thing, but I could do it better. Let's see. Who's on cleaning duty this week? It ain't me. Switch there, I don't have the key, so I can't activate it. Now maybe that's sort of an obtuse way to go about it. But okay, so this is what I'm thinking. This is my theory now. I think Toko did it. Because her alter ego is Genocide Jack. I think Byakuya is kind... Byakuya was talking about like the whole like secret council or whatever that's like controlling everything, and he says his family's on that council. I think Byakuya has discovered that his family might be behind this whole thing. Or at least part of it. So I think that that's where he gets his ego from, like, he can't lose because his whole family's watching, like, they'll make sure nothing happens to him, right? That's what he thinks. I think maybe he will be in for a surprise in that. I think he's gonna die, and I think it's gonna cause a rift upstairs, if you know what I mean. Like the council's gonna be like, how? Why? You weren't supposed to let him do that! Or you weren't supposed to let him get killed, but then they did anyway. And so, I don't know. I can't tell if Byakuya knows that Toko is Genocide Jack. I mean, she's screaming it. There's nothing, like, she's not trying to hide it. She's like, I have to not let Genocide Jack out of the room, place. So that's what she's going on about. Like, I don't know. I think Byakuya, like, doesn't want... I don't think Byakuya's behind this. I don't think he would kill yet. I think he wants the game to keep going. I think maybe he manipulated Toko into killing Chihiro. But then... like, he's also just gonna let her get caught and executed. Because he wants the game to go on. Or maybe... because, like, for somebody so gung-ho about investigating the case, he seems very willfully dismissive of Toko. And everything that's going on with her. So... I don't know. There's holes in that. In his... And, like, what? He happened to find the e-handbooks? Like, I bet he's been using that to his knowledge. I don't know. It seems like it might be a two-man job. One man, one woman. All I know is that whoever is behind Chihiro's murder, I would gladly execute them myself. Because that's unacceptable. You don't kill Chihiro. You especially don't kill Chihiro on my watch. You don't let me see it. You don't let me see you do that. I'm still so mad that I'm so mad. Huh. I feel... ugh. I don't... Chihiro! There's no computer here anymore. That... I find that to be... interesting. Let's look at this extension cord. There's a thick layer of dust on top of the desk. Maybe there's some kind of clue here. Guess not. Yes, there is! Or I look at the outlet. Shelf is packed tight with books, but looking at it, maybe there's some kind of clue here. Guess not. And yet, I get a brown coin for not finding a clue, I guess. What about here? There's some kind of clue here. Nope, no kind of clue there. Do I look at the lamp then? Huh? The lamp won't turn on. Oh, I see. It's not plugged in. The lamp's cord isn't long enough to reach the outlet from here, but last time I saw it, it was definitely on, and it was definitely right here. Oh, that's right. Byakuya was using an extension cord. But there's no extension cord here now. I wonder if... yeah, that's the one. Can we look at the letter again? It made this according... closed down over a year ago. The mastermind probably took over the abandoned school in order to start this killing game, which explains why there aren't any other students, because it's not a real school. Then there's these serious issues that forced the school to close down in the first place. Is there any connection between that and what's happening now? The mastermind's motive. If we can figure that out, will it be enough to get us out of here, or will it totally not? Well, let's go into the documents room. Again. I guess. Yaki is not here. One box is empty. The extension cord was in there before. Yes, we remember. Here's another desk lamp. We don't have all the... we don't appear to have all the clues. But it won't let me notice the fact that there's no computer here anymore, so I'm not sure. No, don't go in. Ugh. I always think that's the door that leads outside. Yeah, leave the archive and leave the library. There's still more need to... you're so wrong. No, there is not. We're done. Camera. So, yeah, that's the way it goes. And the TV monitor. One of the monitors right now is just showing the school crest. Well, great. Great for that. We've seen... Didn't we look at all the shelves? Looking at it, if there's some kind of clue here, guess not. But there is a brown coin. That's a great clue. Do I have to look at this again now? What do you want from me? What do you want from me, game? I'll go back in here and look through all the files again. Oh yeah, that's right. They wanted me to look at the Genocide Jack file again. Okay. I want to take another look at Genocide Jack's case file. I know it was around here somewhere. Huh? It's gone! Did someone take it out of the archive? But the only one who would do something like that... I can't think of anyone but Byakuya! Okay, so now we leave. And we leave completely. Yes, and it lets me. Great. Now I gotta find Byakuya again. Show me the map. Show me Byakuya's dumb face. Why does it say that I've only found 75% of the clues here? Or that's not what it means. But... Show me on the map where people are. Let me go back in here then. Hifumi's still standing there. Like a fatty, fat, fatty. Where's... Yeah, here's you. Mondo and Sakura are there. Nobody's there. It still says I have things to, like, check here. But I guess I have to find Byakuya first and get the case file and then revisit the both scenes again? So where is that slimy little dude? No, it's Yasuhiro. Yasuhiro was not important to me right now. I mean, if they're throwing... I don't know. Like, they're throwing Toko's dissociative identity disorder in everybody's faces, but what if somebody else has it and they're keeping more quiet, more of a lid on it? Where's Byakuya's room? Not if there's any clues. Come on now. Where is he off? Where is he? I've looked everywhere now. Dining hall, Aoi's in there. Celeste is in the warehouse. I guess I have to go to the dining hall? Right, because, like, what's... Aoi's in the dining hall, she's not watching over Toko anymore. What's going on? Oh, Hina, how's Toko doing? Same as before. She won't come out, and she just keeps on mumbling something about Genocide Jack. So I just left her there. You left her? My head was all swimmy, and I was getting pretty hungry.
Yeah!
Oh, but don't worry. I'm gonna head back as soon as I'm done eating. Toko's not exactly pleasant, but I'm still worried about her. Speaking of which, what are you eating?
Huh?
A donut, of course. Of course? There's two things I'm sure God created. Outer space and donuts! Really? I bet Chihiro would have liked to eat more donuts. Maybe that was her one big regret.
Aww,
I should have tried to spend more time with her. Come to think of it, who did she spend time with?
Well...
Yeah, she was a little bit strange. Didn't really hang out with the other girls much. It was like she was trying to keep her distance from us. Actually, Sakura said something similar. She said that even though you and her invited Chihiro to exercise with you, she always refused.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, but it's true. And it wasn't just us, either. It was like she stayed away from all the girls. Was she just shy? I don't know. She talked to the boys all the time. Isn't it kind of weird to be shy around your own sex, but totally fine with the opposite sex?
Ah.
Oh, wait! Maybe. Maybe she was used to guys spoiling her. The law says you can't judge a book by its cover, right? You think so? I never really saw her as that kind of girl. I'm still so lost.
I'm getting tired of waiting. Shall we just plunge right in? It's the moment you've all been waiting for! The class trial!
But there's still so much I'm missing.
You remember where to meet, right?
I think.
Please go through the red door on the first floor of
Maybe it's all supposed to come clean in the trial, you know? It's kind of like the revelation that Sayaka was actually, like, the planner of the murder. We didn't know that going in. That was revealed to us later. Begin the class trial, or... It's about to begin. Okay. Red door is right through here. Okay, we'll do it. If this is as lengthy as the last class trial, this will probably be split up into two episodes also. A part one and a part two. Just because I like you guys so much, so of course they'll be uploaded the same day. And because I can't get enough of playing this game, that I do need to, like, my upload schedule needs to be a little more frequent. Ahem! So, is everyone ready to... What? Am I blind, or are we missing someone?
Yo.
Yeah, Toko's not here.
And Toko is...
You really don't remember?
Kidding! I'm just kidding! How could I forget that little nut job? She's a crucial part of the class trial this time!
What are you gonna do?
Okie dokie! I'll go ahead and drag her out here, kicking and screaming. Just one moment, please!
And just like he said, a few minutes later, he reappeared, dragging Toko behind him.
Yeah! I told him I didn't want to, but he forced me. I can't believe you would drag a girl around. Terrible! You're terrible!
Whew! So now everyone's here, right? Okay then, hustle onto the elevator and let's get this show on the road! I'll see you guys down there!
Let's go.
So, shall we get going? It's time to find out who killed Chihiro.
Chihiro Fujisaki. She was so gentle, so calm and meek. Nobody had any problems with her. Someone made the choice to kill a girl like that. And that murderer is one of us. Someone standing right here.
I gave you plenty to work with. Show us how far your logic can take you. Yeah, okay. Well, I'm... What about Kyoko? What do you got? I don't want to talk to everybody.
Shall we go?
Shall we begin? Yes, we shall begin. I do want to talk to people who may be important to this case. Toko.
Yeah!
Alright, yeah, you're very not liking what's going on here. Also, Celeste.
There is something odd about Toko's behavior. I do not think mere shock is enough to explain it.
And Sakura.
Well, then.
I will uncover the villain who performed such heinous acts on a weaker individual.
Alright.
We have no choice, right? We have to do this.
It's true.
Yes.
I gave a small nod in reply. With one last deep breath, I walked toward the elevator on shaky legs. With each step forward, I could feel my heart starting to race faster and faster. As soon as everyone was on, the elevator began to descend. I couldn't get a handle on my emotions, couldn't stop speculating. The steel box sank with heavy clunking sounds deeper and deeper into the ground. And as we went deeper, the uneasiness in my heart grew bigger and bigger. The elevator was unaffected, however, and continued to descend without hesitation, until finally, it came to a sudden stop.
What do you think? I redecorated! Isn't it so fresh? Isn't it so exciting?
Don't waste our time with stupid questions. Let's get this over with.
Good, good. You're rip-raring to go. Gotta say, I don't hate it. Not at all.
Well...
Okay then, let's get this show on the road! Everyone, please find your assigned seats!
And so, the curtain opened once again. A deadly judgment. A deadly deception. A deadly betrayal, a deadly riddle, a deadly defense, a deadly faith. A deadly class trial!
Yeah, I would like to save the data, please. Thank you. Alright, let's... We can set our... Oh, then now we can set our skills. Okay, so yeah, we've got Melodia's voice. We're also gonna have Algorithm, which we got from Dear Departed Chihiro. May she rest in peace. Increases the speed of memorizing a statement. Effective during the non-stop debate. I don't know what that means, but we've got it. Okay, so these are our truth bullets. Monokuma file number 2. Sakura's account. Locker room dumbbell, the murder weapon. Mondo's account, saying that she wanted to get stronger. Card reader. Main hall e-handbooks. The dead students' handbooks. We have the broken e-handbook, Leon's. Genocide Jack case file. Aoi's account, saying that Chihiro was very shy around girls, but not boys. The boys' locker room carpet, which had the coffee stain. The two locker room posters that looked like they had been switched. We had Chihiro's hand. Which, by the... It makes it seem like the crime took place in the boys' locker room, but then they moved everything into the girls' locker room to see, make it seem like it took place in the girls' locker room. But then... Why would they get... How would Chihiro be in the boys' locker room? I mean, if a boy, like, let her in there... And then Chihiro's handbook was not found and has not been located. Sat at the dead body, she was suspended with the plug. Disappearing stain. Yeah, because the rugs have been switched. The library desk lamp, which has the plug missing, and Celeste's account saying that Chihiro was gonna go that night. Okay. Let's do it. I'm much less confident in this trial than I was in the last
one. Begin with a basic
it just seems like we're missing a lot of
clues. Trial. So, your votes will determine the results.
Or at least I'm missing the logic that ties something together.
If you can figure out who done it, then only they will receive punishment. But if you pick the wrong one, then I'll punish everyone besides the blackened, and the one that deceived everyone else will graduate. Okay, then. So, first off, let's talk about the murder weapon!
First, we have to make clear what was used to deliver the fatal blow.
Obviously, the dumbbell. Yeah, dude, the Genocide Jack case file was used to kill her.
Chihiro's fatal injury. It appears it was a head wound.
Yes.
According to the Monokuma file, the killer used a blunt instrument. But what kind of blunt instrument could it have been?
It was a locker room dumbbell. What?!
Shoot!
I mean,
you're not wrong about it being a blunt instrument. I was just trying to tell you which one it was.
God damn it.
So much for ace in this trial too, already, like just right out of the gate, fail.
Blunt instrument could it have been? I bet it was an iron pipe.
No, you idiot.
Interesting.
Yo, are you kidding?
That certainly would make for a powerful weapon.
What's a hero?
Chihiro's fatal injury. I have to, like, lead the target like this is fucking Sniper Elite 3.
According to the
okay.
Used a blunt instrument. But what kind of blunt instrument?
I love the logic of this game. I love...
I bet it was an iron pipe.
Nah, gotcha. But I hate every single minigame in it.
Can we agree that the object that dealt the fatal blow was the dumbbell? Found at the scene of the crime? It was covered in blood. And there was nothing else at the scene that could have caused that kind of injury.
And the wound on the victim's head is consistent with the shape of the dumbbell. As far as I'm concerned, there's no mistake and no room for doubt on this one.
You looked at her head wound?
Yay! That's so creepy!
If you don't mind, I will proceed from here. Let's move on to discussion of the culprit. Although, I believe the criminal behind this heinous act is already quite clear.
What? For real?
Is he gonna say it's Togo?
Chihiro's killer is the fiendish serial killer, Genocide Jack.
Ah, well, yeah.
Did he really kill Chihiro?
A new element has been added. Oh yeah, I gotta learn about this. For this debate, lines of white noise will appear to disrupt your reactions. Your truth bullets will disappear if they hit these lines, so think of them as obstacles in your debate. But there's a way to keep this white noise from getting in your way. Press the X button to attach the silencer, which you can use to shoot down the white noise. What the fuck? However, if you shoot an actual remark with your silencer instead of the white noise, the time limit will decrease, so take care of Elaine when you have your silencer out. Oh, but if your action difficulty is set to gentle, white noise won't appear at all. Thank God! Good. That's that good. I don't have to deal with that at all. Great. Alright, at this point I would say the Genocide Jack case file is gonna come into play here.
The culprit is Genocide Jack. I'm sure.
Yeah?
Case closed, as far as I'm concerned.
But that's impossible!
Why? What makes it impossible?
Well, I mean, come on! There's just no proof for it!
Wrong. By him.
No, that's wrong!
I might know one reason he could be involved.
What?
I found this file while I was looking around the archive in the library. I guess it's some kind of confidential file the police put together about the Genocide Jack case.
What? That's kind of weird as shit, isn't it? What was something like that doing in the library?
The why of it is probably more trouble than it's worth, so let's forget about that for now. More importantly, it outlines all the specifics of every Genocide Jack case in exceeding detail. According to the file, there appear to be two defining characteristics in every Genocide Jack case. The first is that a bloody message is found written at the scene of every murder.
Oh, that's right. Boob lust.
No. It's actually blood lust.
But more important is the other characteristic, and it's something that has never been made public.
Never made public? What the hell is it?
Why don't you tell them, Makoto?
The other characteristic of every Genocide Jack case?
How the victim was positioned.
Apparently, in every Genocide Jack case, the killer suspends the body in a certain way. Other than the killer, the only people who know about this are the higher-ups in the police department.
However, Chihiro was most definitely suspended in the same way. So, how did the culprit know about this when only high-level police officials were aware of it? There's only one logical answer I can think of. It's because the culprit in this case is the real Genocide Jack.
No fucking way!
You're saying Genocide Jack is one of us?
Yes. In fact, it's Toko.
There we are.
Ugh.
Genocide Jack's true identity is Toko Fukawa.
You lie!
What? Hey, okay, wait, hold on a sec. Toko has, like, bloodophobia or whatever, remember? What kind of serial killer is afraid of blood?
Is Toko Genocide Jack? The answer is yes and no.
Another riddle. Man, why is this gotta be so complicated?
It does seem like a riddle in a way, but I feel like I can just about see it. Genocide Jack is Toko, but isn't Toko. What does it mean?
Hangman's Gambit. Okay. Oh, we got six letters. H-I. What? What? I don't have a damn clue. Shh.
What? Oh, ship. Oh, cheer. I'm so confused. Dissociative identity disorder, split personality. None of these don't fit in here. It has to be a vowel first. I'm just gonna go with O. Nope, that's a miss. Okay, then it has to be I. Nope, that's a miss also. Is it C then? Schizo? Shits. Skits. Yo, that is so... I hate that. I hate that so much.
Now I understand.
Nobody says schizo. I mean, they do. But that's not the word that I would have put in there.
Huh?
I think I read that somewhere in the file.
That was a dirty trick. I don't like that at all.
They thought that the suspect might have... What did they call it? Dissociative identity disorder.
Oh, okay. But still, to go and say that about Miss Fukawa is...
Perfectly acceptable. Toko's strange behavior after seeing the body is proof enough that she has a split personality.
The one thing that shows Toko could have a split personality... Her behavior change! Obviously!
You're that talking is the... about how she
it has something to do with her behavior. Oh, her behavior change? Yeah, that's it!
That's right. Think back. She fainted when she saw Chihiro's corpse, and then, when she woke up...
Funny, that's for sure. That melancholy tone of hers completely disappeared.
Don't go assigning adjectives to my tone without permission.
Not to mention, once she regained consciousness and saw Chihiro's body again, she was utterly calm. In other words, within her is one personality that can handle blood, and one that obviously can.
So when Toko trapped herself in her room, it's because she was scared of Genocide Jack?
I won't let Genocide Jack have control. I'll drive out the killer. Drive out the murderous fiend.
The reason she locked herself in her room wasn't to keep other people from getting in. It was to keep her other personality from getting out.
What?
Toko was afraid. Afraid of the murderous fiend inside of her. Of killing even more people.
How?
Yeah. How can you know all this?
I do believe you misunderstood her. What she's trying to say isn't, how can you know all this? No. What she wants to know is, how could you tell them?
Huh?
Last night, just before Monokuma gave his motive speech, Toko and I had a strange conversation. She told me a most interesting story. She said a murderous fiend lived within her, and she was afraid it could appear and attack at any time. And that trepidation is what's caused her to have such a bleak attitude. Isn't that right, Toko?
This is all a lie. Right, Toko?
You said you wouldn't tell anyone.
What?
You promised! I can't believe you lied!
You have only yourself to blame. You came to me with your tragic little story. I didn't ask you to. This is the real world, not some romantic fantasy fairy tale. Besides, you broke your promise first. You said that as long as you were here, no matter what, you wouldn't let Genocide Jack kill anyone. But in spite of that promise,
I'm sorry. I couldn't keep our promise. Oh, that was the promise. But don't worry. Never again. I won't let Genocide Jack have control ever again.
No, you won't, because you'll be executed.
If I kept my promise, you would go out with me. That's the only reason I promised.
How many times do I have to tell you? I never said that, but you weren't able to do it. You just couldn't resist that rush you got from killing, could you?
I tried. I swear I tried to control it, but...
Does that mean Genocide Jack counts as a dude, and that's why she could go in the boys' locker?
Your efforts were useless. What a disappointment.
No, this is gonna turn back around on Byakuya.
I hate you.
Well, the opening act is nearly finished. All that's left is to hear from the person in question directly.
The person?
I don't think... Oh, okay, no. She didn't do it. She didn't do it. Byakuya is manipulating the whole thing. He did it, and he's gonna blame her for it. And she thinks she did it, because she's not in control when she's Genocide Jack. He's taking advantage of this.
You don't mean...
Toko's body suddenly lunged backwards. A huge thud echoed across the courtroom. But in the next second...
Is it me you were hoping to see?
Ugh, Genocide Jill.
Yes, what the heck? So you figured it out, huh? Well, whatever. What are you gonna do? I'm the ultimate murderous fiend, Genocide Jack! Or better yet, let's go with Genocide Jill!
What the fuck is this? Toko, what happened to you?
Not Toko, that's a loser name. And what happened is a textbook split personality. One of them happens to be a serial killer. You should turn a blind eye to one's fault.
So intense.
Like they say, sound and murderous mind, sound and murderous body.
This one is so different from the one we've come to know.
Yes, well, the world is composed of a front and a back, you know. Just like how every inning has a top and a bottom, or how in the depths of every truth lives a little lie.
Okay, so I think Genocide Jill is gonna come back and turn it all on Byakuya now.
Behind every dark and gloomy soul lives another that shines as bright as the sun!
I don't know, I mean there has to be more to this because this is too early for this kind of reveal. There's so much more evidence to go through.
This is the murderous fiend Genocide Jack? This is beyond insane!
Miss Jack, Jill, can I ask you a question?
What's up?
Some of us think you might be the mastermind behind our entire situation. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, I'll tell you, I am the mastermind of all masterminds! Just kidding!
Then, it's not true?
Of course it's not true! How dare you try to link me to that creepazoid! And another thing, the police and government and society in the outside world are totally powerless! I mean, they just let this idiotic bloodthirsty maniac go buck wild all over town!
Sure, I'm a bloodthirsty maniac, but life is pain, right? To live is to hurt other people. It's a necessary evil if you want to survive. The act of living itself causes pain for everyone.
Just kidding again!
This should be enough to convince you. This murderous fiend is responsible for Chihiro's death. There's clearly a motive, so there should be no doubt.
A motive?
Remember what Monokuma told us? If someone didn't murder and graduate within 24 hours, an embarrassing memory or secret would be revealed. Well, let's assume that Toko's secret was about Genocide Jack. If a secret like that came to light, Toko's life would have undoubtedly been forever ruined. So she had a very clear motive to never have that side of herself exposed.
Interesting. Very, very, very interesting. But sorry, as much as I hate to admit it, I'm not the culprit.
Huh?
But I cannot imagine anyone other than you could murder someone in such a bizarre fashion.
It was Byakuya.
Maybe so, but nevertheless, it's the truth.
Do you really expect any of us to believe you?
Yeah. I could never believe a word you say, you monster!
Maybe she's totally right about that, but something's still bothering me. What she said. I need to get some more details about all this.
Alright, what do we have? Library desk lamp, status of the dead body, disappearing stain.
Sorry, but I didn't kill anyone!
You say that, but do you really expect any of us
to... Alright, we're gonna probably have to let all the dialogue go at least once, just so I know which bullet to use.
Oh, an alibi, huh? Now we're talking!
When you compare your past murders to this incident, the modus operandi matches completely. What more proof do we need? Give it up. You killed her.
Sorry, but I didn't kill anyone!
You say that, but do you really expect any of us to believe it?
Perhaps if you had an alibi, that would change things.
Oh, an alibi, huh? Now we're talking!
When you compare your past murders to this incident, the modus operandi matches completely.
Why did I press X by accident? Hey, this appears to be right. I don't know.
Methods of murder
honestly.
Really exactly the same? I'm not so sure about that. I think there's a slight difference between the Genocide Jack cases and this one.
Huh? How's it any different?
Uh-oh, you don't know? Well then, human garbage, let me tell you! I murder with passion and conviction. I consider myself a professional, and I have a very particular way of doing things. Imagine you go to a fancy Italian restaurant.
Yeah, like Chihiro only got hit over the head once with one object that wasn't even like stuck into her. Also, they're always scissors.
But what happened to Chihiro? It'd be like if that same Italian restaurant started using Ragu or Chef Boyardee. This is no creation of mine.
Let me rephrase that in a way that maybe makes more sense. There are two clear differences between the Genocide Jack cases and this one.
There's one clear difference. The victim's fatal injury.
A gun! For one, the cause of death is different. In the Genocide Jack murders, all the victims were killed the same way. According to the case file, they were all apparently killed with a pair of scissors. But Chihiro died from a blow to the head, right?
Ah, yes. That is remarkably different from the other murders.
Wouldn't it be strange for someone who kills the same way without fail to suddenly change their method? And there's more. One more.
It depends on if the girl's sewing kits have scissors in them, which I think they would.
That's right. In my recipe of murder, if the bloody message is the tortellini...
So if she had scissors and had the ability to use them, there's no reason she would deviate.
The arrangement of the body would be the pesto sauce.
Could you please stop comparing killing people to cooking?
So, are you saying the other difference has to do with how the body was arranged?
That's right. The second difference is related to how she was suspended. What was used to suspend her?
A gun!
The plug.
Do you remember what the killer used to suspend her? They used some kind of rope to hang her up by her wrists.
What is your point?
Well, in all the previous Genocide Jack cases, something else was used to suspend them. Specifically, pairs of razor-sharp scissors.
What? I use my own specially designed scissors for the murders and the arrangement! Like I said, I'm a professional, so naturally I'm very picky about the tools I use. And you know what else? Big Mac said there's two differences, but he's wrong.
Big Mac? Are you referring to me?
Listen up, Big Mac! There's actually one more difference!
Huh?
My word, you really didn't notice? Take a look at who the victims were in each Genocide Jack case. There's a pattern there, just waiting to be discovered.
They're all dudes, aren't they?
A pattern?
Figure that out, and it'll be plain as death why I couldn't have possibly
killed that little lolly girl.
Let's see. There was a pattern, and Chihiro didn't fit it? I think I figured it out!
Because Chihiro was her lover, please.
I got it! Is it because Chihiro was a girl?
Bingo! Bullseye right on the money!
Byakuya's daft as fuck, then.
What are you talking about?
In all the genocide Jack cases,
he got like every single thing wrong.
Something in common.
Ken Harada 32, Tetsuhiro Honda 17, Shoji Gaku, Kanoise, Takeshi Yoshida, Tomatsuna, and a bunch more dude names.
They were all guys?
That's right! The people I kill with such passion and conviction are all adorable little men! I can't believe I said it! I'm so embarrassed!
The hell is wrong with you?
I can't help it! I'm just a full-throttle boy-on-boy fangirl! And the mopey side of me just hates it! But now I'm on the fast track to becoming a full-blood fan madam!
So since Chihiro was a girl and not an adorable little man, you wouldn't kill her?
Would an Italian chef suddenly start making ramen just because they're both noodles? Don't be stupid. I have too much passion and conviction to cross that line. That's the absolute reality of the one and only.
We get it. You've clearly explained your hobby and your philosophy. But that's not all there is to it. It's a different matter entirely when you're forced to kill in order to survive.
Quiet, lowly cur!
Lowly cur?
I would never kill for a reason as petty as mere survival. And if by some fluke I did kill to survive, why would I bother with the message and arrangement? It'd make me the obvious suspect!
That does make some amount of sense.
Plus, whatever reason I have for killing, I would never leave out my prized scissors. Who would go out of their way to use a big, stupid, heavy dumbbell?
Maybe you used the dumbbell because you couldn't find any scissors in the school?
Any scissors? I don't just use any scissors! I only use my own set of high-class envy of the entire world!
Okay, so then the sewing kit doesn't matter.
Okay, whatever. There still aren't any in the school.
Are you sure about that? Da-da-da-da!
Uh-oh.
She's fully equipped!
That's right! So I can go anywhere, anytime! Why would I resort to dumbbells or rope when I have my trusty scissors by my side? Go ahead, tell me I'm wrong! You can you gutter dogs, all of you! Not to mention, I have no clue how to tie a good knot! The rope's totally out of the question anyway!
I have no idea what's going on anymore! Could such a heinous villain really be innocent?
But the body really was suspended, right? And nobody but the police knew about that.
Yeah. That's why we figured it had to be the real deal, and not some...
That sucks, because if Toko doesn't get executed, she's just gonna be alive and in the school and just around everyone again.
Actually, hold on, there is one person. One person who could have copied the Genocide Jack case.
Why, it's Byakuya.
Here's my answer! Byakuya, it's possible you could have found out, isn't it? You'd have no problem gaining access to classified government documents or internal police records. Plus, you'd already looked through the Genocide Jack file before this all happened, hadn't you?
Are you saying Mr. Togami did it?
Then, the reason he pushed the theory of Genocide Jack being the killer so hard was because he wanted to pin the crime on her.
So, he rearranged the scene to disguise it and make it look like I put my stamp on it! The adorable glasses man was behind it all! Oh, I'm on fire!
Well, Byakuya, what's your response?
I see. So now the suspicion falls on me. Then I must ask, when would you say I began acting suspicious? Surely you must have an answer.
Looking back and thinking about it now, the way you were acting right before we discovered the body was a little strange.
And the locker rooms, they're suspicious. Very suspicious indeed. Wouldn't you agree?
Huh? Suspicious?
It seems nobody searched the locker rooms. Let's start with the girls' locker room.
You wanted to go to the girls' locker room right away, right? But since you're a guy...
I should have naturally thought of the boys' locker room first. Is that what you want to say? The victim was Chihiro, a girl. Hence why I said we should check the girls' locker room.
Nothing strange about that, I'd say.
On the contrary, there's something very strange.
Okay, then. What's so strange about it? Go ahead. Share with the rest of the class.
There was a clear contradiction in what Byakuya just said. I need to make it clear to everyone. A new element has been added to nonstop debates. Dear God, what? Next, we're going to add something called a truth flashback. If you aim at a weak spot and hold down the triangle button, then you'll memorize that weak spot. This memorized phrase can only be shot once as a single truth bullet. If you shoot or change the truth bullet, it will disappear from your truth cylinder. However, you can use this flashback feature as many times as you want. If you don't seem to have the answer to a lie or contradiction in your loaded truth bullets, it might be wise to memorize a different weak spot and use that to make your case. Oh boy! In this case, though, I will say that if you don't use a flashback, you won't be refuting anything. So we have to use a flashback. Great. We have to hold triangle on a thing.
So, you said Byakuya was acting kind of weird before we found the body.
Yeah.
But he was acting weird... how?
If you're presented with the opportunity to check out the girls' locker room,
you absolutely take it! That's a natural reaction for any guy!
The victim was Chihiro, who was a girl. So, of course, I would suggest we check the girls' locker room first. There was no time for pointless distractions. What's so strange about that?
I wish you'd taken me with you.
Ah, what? I have no idea. Hearing Byakuya's comment about Chihiro being a girl, I realize there's a clear contradiction there. Why is there a contradiction there?
So, you said Byakuya was acting kind of weird before we found the body. But he was acting weird... how?
If you're presented with the opportunity to check out the girls' locker room,
you absolutely take it! That's a natural reaction for any guy!
The victim was Chihiro, who was a girl.
Oh, you didn't know that it was Chihiro. You had to... We didn't know who the victim was before we went in there.
I'll tell you what's so strange about that, because up until we actually discovered the body, we couldn't have known who the victim was. So your claim that you went to the girls' locker room first because Chihiro was the victim doesn't hold up.
I see. That's a good answer, I must admit. Interesting. Very interesting indeed. But your reasoning is still too weak.
Huh?
What's wrong? Is that it? Surely you've got more than that. Go ahead. Show us.
What's with Byakuya's attitude? It's like he doesn't even care. I've got him cornered, but he's acting like it has nothing to do with him.
What's the matter? You're not finished already, are you? There must be more to it.
There is. I think.
There is more to it. Think about it. We just talked about the differences between this case and past Genocide Jack incidents. The proof you're looking for is hidden in there.
Oh? Proof that I'm the culprit, you mean?
The differences between this case and other Genocide Jack murders. The evidence that proves Byakuya is responsible is hidden in there? What could it be? Okay, what do we have? Library desk lamp, Celeste's account, disappearing stain. Right?
Chihiro was suspended with... it was some kind of rope.
Yeah, it's gonna be library desk lamp.
That's right! It absolutely was!
Then there must be something very fishy indeed about that rope.
Hey, Byakuya, where'd you get it from, huh?
I'd never seen that rope before in my life.
That's wrong!
No, that's wrong!
Damn!
Actually, I'm pretty sure you have seen it before. Because, you see, that rope, Or should I say, that extension cord?
What? An extension cord?
Byakuya, you've used the extension cord in the library more than once, haven't you? And the same extension cord that was in the library all this time went missing after the murder. And there's no way someone who uses that extension cord as much as you do wouldn't discover that fact.
And Byakuya must be the one who took the extension cord. I can't imagine any other possibility.
That's really what you think? Then your conclusion is something like this? I killed Chihiro in the girls' locker room, then hung her up and wrote that bloody message. I intentionally made it look like Genocide Jack was behind it. Is that about right?
He's doing it again. He's totally calm, totally unconcerned. As if he's not even involved. Wait, not even involved?
What's wrong? I asked you if you think that's what happened.
Hell yes, that's what happened. So that's it, right? Byakuya's the killer.
I don't disagree with not disagreeing.
He kept calling this a game, right? So he'd be totally willing to do something like this to win.
Sorry, but could we hold on just a second? I think we need to talk about this a little more.
Huh? Do we really need to? We've already decided who did it.
I know, but still, there's something that's still bothering me.
Is that right? And what, pray tell, is still bothering you? I killed her in the girls' locker room, then disguised my crime. Specifically, I dressed it up to make it look like it was the work of a homicidal psychopath. What about all that bothers you?
Wait, what was that just now? Something's not right. Byakuya's remarks just now, there's something in there that concerns me.
The scene of the crime.
I got it! You say you killed Chihiro in the girls' locker room, right? But are you sure about that? Isn't it possible that the murder took place somewhere else?
How disappointing. What kind of question is that? Even in the world of disappointments, this is a true letdown. She was found dead in the girls' locker room. There is absolutely no question about that. How could the scene of the crime have been anywhere else?
Well, I think it's entirely possible that she was killed somewhere else, then carried there later, along with the rest of the murder scene.
The rest of the murder scene? That was awfully specific. Please tell me you have a reason for saying all of that.
I believe I do.
Hey, Byakuya, did I just take you off guard? When the story suddenly moved to the crime scene, Byakuya, who'd been so confident up till now, maybe Byakuya never even realized that the actual scene of the crime could have been somewhere else.
Hey, don't just move on without permission!
What the hell's going on in this trial?
Come on, Makoto. If there's any chance the murder took place somewhere else, let's see the proof.
Evidence that shows the things that got switched are the poster and the boys' locker room carpet. Well, let's start with the posters.
I got it! The proof that she was killed somewhere else is the poster that's hanging in each locker room.
Your proof is some posters?
The poster in the girls' locker room was a picture of a big-boobed supermodel. But don't you think that's kind of strange? Why would the girls' locker room have a poster like that?
I bet those massive jugs of hers were totally fake!
Meanwhile, the boys' locker room had a poster of the super popular boy band Tornado. Again, that doesn't really seem to belong in a boys' locker room.
So you're saying that maybe the posters were switched?
And there's one other thing I noticed about the locker rooms. You know what I'm talking about, right, Sakura?
You're referring to my protein coffee, aren't you?
Protein coffee?
While I was in the girls' locker room earlier, I spilled some protein coffee on the carpet. But I noticed that after the murder, the stain had been totally scrubbed away.
No, it's not that the stain was scrubbed away. It was moved.
Boys' locker room carpet. Yep.
I got it! The stain on the girls' locker room carpet wasn't scrubbed away. In fact, I found it on the boys' locker room carpet.
That's definitely the stain from my protein coffee.
Then, does that mean that the carpets were switched too? But why would anyone do that?
To move the murder scene from one locker room to the other. It's certainly plausible, don't you think?
What?
In other words, in order to completely swap the scene of the crime, the bloodstained poster and carpet were moved along with the dead body. By doing this, the killer was able to change the entire room where the murder took place.
I can certainly follow your reasoning, but why would the culprit bother doing that?
Yeah, I don't know the answer to that either.
Huh? Why would they go through all that trouble of switching the scene of the crime? Actually, an even bigger question. If the murder did take place in the boys' locker room, then how did Chihiro get in the boys' locker room in the first place? Ah! To get into the locker rooms, you have to swipe your e-handbook across the card reader device. But Chihiro's handbook should have only allowed her access to the girls' locker room. She had
yeah,
no
so
way
she hacked.
To get into
did
the
she
boys'
hack
locker
Leon's?
Room to begin with.
But then how did she know where they were?
Oh, she did have a way, and I can tell you what it was.
I highly doubt that.
Shut up! I'm telling you, I know how she could have done it.
Is he right? Could Chihiro really have gotten into the boys' locker room somehow?
Boys' locker room carpet. Broken e-handbook. It's gonna be broken e-handbook. That's the only thing that's relevant to this conversation right now.
Is it really possible? Could Chihiro really have gotten into the boys' locker room somehow?
Ah! I got it! She must have hacked her e-handbook!
No. Damn it! You think you have some proof that contradicts what I said? No! I'm sorry!
Is it really possible?
Well, but it's... like, she didn't hack her own, she took Leon's.
Locker room somehow.
Ah! I got it!
Did she do both?
She must have hacked her e-handbook. She was the ultimate programmer, after all. I'm sure that would have been no problem for her.
No, I don't think that's it.
See, he's even like...
main hall.
Huh? What thing?
He contradicted it for me.
About Leon's handbook, of course.
Yeah, like, that's right, so I'm not...
She could get into the boys' locker room no problem.
Yo, what? Theoretically, if Chihiro was able to use it, she could get into the boys' locker room. But that's if she was able to use it.
Is it really possible?
So because it's broken, it couldn't have been Leon's? Or she couldn't have used Leon's because it was broken?
She must have hacked her e-handbook! She was the ultimate programmer, after all. I'm sure that would have been no problem for her.
No, I don't think that's it. She used the thing that was in the main hall.
Huh? What thing?
Wait for it.
I'm talking about Leon's handbook, of course.
Okay, thanks you for not missing, because it looked like it was gonna miss.
No, I don't think Chihiro used Leon's handbook.
Why not?
Because Leon's handbook was broken.
Oh. Well, then, yeah, I guess that'd be pretty impossible, huh?
I am struck silent by how quickly you gave up.
Plus, isn't there a regulation against using someone else's handbook?
Actually, the rule states that loaning your handbook is prohibited. It says nothing about borrowing one. In other words, you could borrow a dead person's handbook all you want, and you'd be safe.
Yup, yup, yup! Hit the nail square on the noggin!
Of course, if it were broken, that wouldn't make any sense anyway.
So then, she must have hacked hers, like I said. She used her ultimate programmer skills and...
Psst! You can't fix an e-handbook! The instant you open one up, a security buzzer starts blaring!
So, if she didn't use Leon's handbook, and she didn't modify her own handbook...
Maybe Mr. Naegi's initial assumption is just... wrong?
It seems like there's no way she could have got into the boys' locker room. So I guess so.
Okay then, I vote for Byakuya!
Is that it then? Chihiro was killed in the girls' locker room, and Byakuya's the one who did it? Really? But still, I don't know what else I can do.
Hold on a second. I agree with you though. I think you're on the right track.
That's gonna do it for this episode. You know, I'm gonna do upload part two because we're in an hour and 4 minutes. So just, you know, we're get right to it. But like, share, and subscribe and whatnot. And I'll see you guys real soon.